Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to eat and run here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Happy Saturday, Mosh Pit, not Friday. Sorry about the confusion of the day of the week. We are still waiting for another video to cross 3,000 likes. A little bit of a slower week in the Isaac series, but to be expected with the quality of runs we've been having so far. Hopefully June picks up because, man, we're getting close to the through the first half of June, and it's been rough. As you all have plainly seen here. Here's your meme of the day, tweet of the day, also maybe our first ever Godzilla meme of the day. Sent in by LRay13. Title thread was, Godzilla brisket. And this is a screenshot of someone else's tweet who said, Shin Godzilla looks like some delicious brisket. And I hate how accurate it kind of is because, man, it does look good. Now, before I take this picture off of the screen, if you're picking the top right, or yeah, top right, bottom left, or bottom right, which one are you picking for the best brisket? I'm not going to count Shin Godzilla. It's, for me, it's definitely bottom left. I don't care what anyone says. That is the cakiest, meatiest, juiciest looking brisket that I've seen in a while, and that's the one I'm picking. Let me know in the comments down below. Top on in and get rocking and rolling, please, and for the love of everything, give us a better start than we have been taking, and oof. Kilo 1-3 Charlie G Fop. Well, we've got, okay stats, I guess. I mean, our damage is good, but man, our movement speed is not. I am happy that at least we have the pinking shears, which is going to help us really, really alleviate a lot of these early damage problems that we've been seeing, and we're going to immediately give it up for Shubu. Actually, no, we're not. No. Overall, Shubtawoop does way less damage than the pinking shears do against bosses. And we are primarily going to be using the pinking shears against bosses. So as much as I love Shoop, and don't get me wrong, I love me some Shoop, I think that we have to be smart here and play against the... We're basically going up against our futures. What in the world? Sarah? Oh, I guess that's because we've got the adoption papers, yeah. Oh, okay, well... I'm going to do that then because, I mean, Seraphim is definitely a bro, and I'm going to take a little bit of a withdrawal here and get Seraphim, even though we're already 2 of 3 for conjoin, which I really don't like. Seraphim is a fair bit of damage extra that we could take here, so we are going to get the soul hearts. I'm not going to pick them up right now, though. You might be saying, hang on, Seraphim Richter. I don't know what voice this is. Hang on, Seraphim Richter. Why are you not doing it? How come you're not taking it now? Well, the reason being not Cletus is because I don't want to take any damage on the soul hearts before the next floor. So it's easier for us to get out of the curse room, go pick up a half heart, and then go back in the curse room. Maybe we get a movement speed upgrade. Maybe we can actually get a full charge on the pinking shears and somehow get out fast enough. I mean, it's not going to happen because obviously I'm going to use it against Gemini here, but you know what I mean. Look at this. We do have a tinted rock here as well. So Gemini moving fast enough to get away from the pinking shears, and we get bloody nothing from the boss. And, you know, that's just how it goes. So I am tempted to go into the secret room there. But first, I am going to go take these soul hearts, like we said. And then we can go back and buy another soul heart down. Yeah. I could have bought a bomb, but I'm choosing not to. I'm hoping that we at least get a bomb from this tinted rock, or two bombs. I know that the super secret room is there. It technically, I guess, could be there too, but I know it's there. I'm gonna bomb this here, and we got, okay. Well, we got more soul hearts than we know what to do with, and I'm fine with that. Really quickly here, I will mention that we had a new shakeup in the top 5 patrons on Patreon. So, just letting you know, the names have changed at the end of this video. And thank you all very much for those of you who are a member of the Patreon Mosh Pit. It does help out a lot. It goes towards paying for music stuff. I am planning on doing a better revamp of the Patreon. At some point this year, it's like one of those things. It's one of those things that is just like another thing to do. What? Oh, did it give us this? Gave us a sticky nickel, didn't it? But it is on the menu. It is on the planning board here as we end up getting Virgo. Virgo is going to give us neutral or positive pills whenever we do take pills. So it doesn't identify them like PhD, but it does guarantee that we're at least going to be able to have them neutral or positive. The movement speed up. Happy with that. Not happy that we walked to a curse room that is absolutely useless. But we've got the soul hearts to spare, so, you know, it's whatever. Nice. Now we get a unicorn poop. Now this is huge because we can go back and play this temperance machine and possibly, yeah, there you go, get the Virgo shield, which was the other part of, about Virgo that I was about to mention. So Virgo has the best on-proc shield in the game by far. It's very, very long-lasting. It can proc multiple times in a row. I don't believe it has any effect on... I don't believe it inherits any of that chance from your luck rating, but it is extremely powerful. And look at that. We end up getting a lot more money than we should have really ever gotten here. I do want that nickel as well. Let's see if we can get another proc on Virgo now. Really, really supercharging our early game economy here. I mean, I don't know if this is a valid complaint or not, but I feel like if I'm trading my HP for a temperance machine tap, it shouldn't give me a sticky nickel. I'm just saying. Just call me kooky, call me crazy. I'm just looking for a little bit of fairness here, game. I'm not going to bomb the temperance machine yet because obviously there's still maybe some potential to get even more money. But we're looking good so far. We are okay. So before I get ahead of myself here, going on to last week's question of the episode, this is sent in by Nathan Wright 6282 from the Mega Man episode, which I had a little bit of fun with on the thumbnail. Thanks to Alex. He did a great job. I didn't really give him a whole lot of detail to go into, but he did a phenomenal job, as always. And if you want to follow Alex, go check him out in the links down below. I link his anytime I use any of his art in any of my videos, I will always link and credit the artist. And if you ever have if you ever have difficulty trying to find him, you can always find them in the YouTube information video description down below. That is, I always have his contact information. So a couple people said that they couldn't find how to contact him, and that's mind blowing to me because it's literally in every video. But going on to Nathan's question of the episode, Nathan said, if you were to do an Isaac series of video, or if you do a series of videos on Isaac with another YouTuber, who would you do it with? I would love to do it with Ryan. He and I have played games for, we're going on 8 years now together. And we have never played Isaac together. If we have, it was like for a one-off thing. For like either, oh wow, there's two sticky nickels there. It was either a one-off thing or something that like wasn't super important. That would be the dream, to be able to just to do a series with Ryan. Now, that's probably never going to happen. I'm just going to be real with you. But it would be cool. You know what? I will take the half-price ladder. You never know where that's going to take you. So, yeah, I would love to do something with Ryan. If you don't know who Ryan is, it's Northern Lion. We've been friends for many, 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 many years. And it would be surreal to be able to do Isaac with him at some point. He was in the Ultimate Isaac Tournament 2, but that was like, I don't know how long ago. Of course, the maze here. Our damage only looks good because of Little Brimmy and Seraphim. Our actual damage is about as par as it gets. I would say it is as mid as it gets. The real big thing that's hamstringing us right now is our lack of tiers. Shot speed is okay. 1.08 is fine, but we need a tiers rate upgrade badly. Especially if we're going to have shielded tiers, which is the whole reason why I do not like shielded tiers. Is the main reason why is because your tiers have to interact with enemy tiers. Now, we end up getting technology, which is going to help that out greatly. But we still need tiers, though. Tech 1, one of my favorite items of all time. It just takes care of you. And, you know, with shielded tiers now, having piercing and essentially unlimited range, we do not have to worry about ever, and I mean ever, getting hit by projectiles again. I'm going to buy the bomb and then bomb the keeper. This might seem a little bit of a weird move, but it's because I want to raise the chance of us getting either a devil deal or an angel deal But more importantly, with Diplopia now, we could be balling out of control with a really strong devil deal. Apologies for all the coughing here. The cough has come back. It still really hasn't even gone away from the subathon. Just, you know, talking lots and lots and lots. I've been streaming lots, too. I am making it my mission, maybe not in the month of June, but definitely starting in July for the second half of the year. I'm making it my mission to start streaming more on YouTube again. It's been too long since I've talked to the YouTube mosh pit. I'm going to just gonna take the hermit card because I don't feel like being in there. So my plan is hopefully to do, I would love to do at least once a week stream on YouTube. And I wouldn't necessarily just, got two hermit cards. I wouldn't necessarily just be playing Isaac. Some people actually would want to see some of the Pokemon breaks. They said they would love to see some of that. Other games I've been playing, obviously I've been playing lots of Diablo 4. Diablo 4 is, the more I play it this season, the more I'm definitely down for it. It's turned a corner for me. I've been playing a majority of that on stream lately. And other games too. You know, like I've been playing Fallout Shelter online, which has been a lot of fun. There's a plethora of games that I'm slowly kind of branching out towards again. But of course, there'll be mostly Isaac here on YouTube. We do get a Tears upgrade, thankfully. Shot speed does not matter for us. Blood of the Martyr, we could double this. I'm not going to, though. I think that Diplopia is just too valuable not to have, especially for boss rush. The Curse of the Maze here. Yeah, we will not be able to get out of this room. I'm just gonna use the Hermit Guard. We could, what I was thinking about doing, I was gonna try to use the Razor Blade to get out of the Curse Room for free. But there's no way that we'd be able to use the Razor Blade and also get Diplopia back. Now, if we had the school bag, that'd be something different, but we don't. A couple people have asked me whenever I mention streaming on YouTube here in the Isaac videos, how come I just don't do a multicast or a simulcast? And the main reason for that is because I don't want to manage two chats, because YouTube chat tends to be a lot more busy since there's exponentially more viewers on YouTube than there are on Twitch. And I don't want to miss anyone's messages, but I also want to make sure that, you know, everyone still gets the same amount of attention. You know, I'm able to interact with chat and I'm not just like missing things left and right. If it's YouTube alone, I can pretty easily handle YouTube alone. Twitch alone, I can pretty easily handle that, but combining the two might be a little bit too hectic for me. And I don't think that people would feel like it's a usual type stream. Like I'm very close and very talkative when it comes to the mosh pit on Twitch and on YouTube, and I don't want to sully that experience for anybody on either side. A third Curse of the Maze in a row. That's fun. Although I was thinking about doing a Twitch mosh pit versus YouTube mosh pit in like a subathon type deal for a birthday. Maybe we'll do something like that for next year's birthday, I don't know. But I also don't want to give like the wrong impression to people being like, you know, he's now taking advantage of two of his types of fan base to get money. Like, no, I mean, obviously I do this for money. I mean, this is my job. I'm supposed to. I'm not doing it for money by this point. I'm something's wrong, but obviously it's more than just that. And I thought that, wow, that was a super late spawn on that mega troll bomb. Yeah, I thought that would be a good one-off type of event, or maybe once a year event. pit the YouTube mosh pit versus the Twitch mosh pit in a friendly competition, of course. We would have had Spun had I taken experimental treatment, which that's the only circumstance where I would actually take that garbage item. But yeah, I mean, I don't think anyone would really mind that much. Juggling the two chats to make sure that I'm able to pay attention to everyone would be a little bit testing, but I think I'd be able to do it. Especially like since, you know, it basically allows you to you can combine the chats and like the UI and stuff. So I've never used a restreamer. I've never used a simulcast program. So it would be all new to me. I have to use a bomb here because we picked up the ladder. So we are surprisingly flying through this run despite us not having incredible damage. And the main reason for that is because of the fact we have Lil Brimmy and Seraphim. Now, Tech 1 is helping, obviously. But us having Lil Brimstone is really, really, really carrying the biggest load here for us. Seraphim takes care of him up close. Lil Brimmy takes care of him from afar. And if we somehow manage to miss with the Brimstone shot, then we get followed up with the Tech 1 shots, and we're cruising right now. Actually, pretty impressive considering our stats. Now, obviously, we would like to use Diplopia at some point, and not wait all the way to the chest. And there's no one saying that we're going to have to go to the chest. Wow. We're going to have to go to the chest here, but we need to start curving out this power here very quickly. Otherwise, I'm not going to use this pill yet because I don't know if it's a telepills or not. Fear of the Night, we'll take it. It's piercing. It gives us piercing and spectral, but hey, look at that. We got tears up. What was this other card over here? I done forgot. Didn't know. Tower card. We could use Diplopia to get the smelter. And I guess that other item, but honestly, I think that's a waste of Diplopia. All right, Diplopia, this is what we've held on to you for so long. Now, I know it's not your fault, and I know you can't control what items we're going to see. However, I'm hoping that we finally get to utilize you a bit. That's my hope and dream. Now, one thing would be really nice to see here is a 5 room, as we could do boss rush again, but instead it's going to be a full reroll and... I really don't think it's necessary to reroll Tech 1 here. Tech 1 is going to be our ace in the hole if we end up getting some more damage, which right now, as you see here, I mean, with Spectral Tears and Piercing, it's going to help us out greatly, but it's not the end-all be-all. I want to use our last key here accidentally. The Golden Bomb, okay. We gain another key. Wow, they mixed a skeleton hand with a regular hand. That's something right there. Yeah. A fool card was there. But honestly, I don't think we're going to need to come back out. But we're just looking for the item room and the shop. The fact that we haven't seen it at this point tells me that we are looking at a adjacent situation with the shop and the item room. I'm happy that at least we have some resemblance of a pretty decent run here so far anyway. I don't want to jinx myself now. Let's not get crazy. Health up, speed up. Very nice. Virgo definitely paying dividends here. Got our half heart back from the curse room, and lo and behold, look at that. It's almost as if I played this game before. Whew, I don't know how we didn't get hit by that shot. We got in the door right at the nick of time. We don't actually want starter deck here because the problem with starter deck is that it takes all of our pills and turns them into cards. And that's not necessarily a good thing with Virgo. We have lots of stats we need to improve upon. Did we just get another strength card? Oh, okay. And yeah, as I predicted, we don't need to get out of boss rush at this point. Well, that's not true. I take that back because I don't necessarily want to do boss rush. So I will go in this room. I mean, it's not. The only reason why I skipped this room is just because I didn't feel like dealing with the mom hands. Okay. Now that we've gotten our full clear out of the way, plenty of time to make boss rush here. I'm going to go for damage here just because we really, really, really need some. And you get more damage here. But now all eyes are on the boss rush and it is terrible. All right. Well, I guess we can take Aquarius. Aquarius or... Yeah, we'll take Camo Undies instead. I mean, Camo Undies works very nicely with Tech 1, so. And I, at this point, I don't know where the secret room is, and honestly, I don't care anymore. Okay, there's the secret room. I knew it was there. The half soul heart thanks to the Blessed Penny, and we'll head on to Zaun. We had some kind of mapping that definitely would be nice, but we did gain a significant amount of damage on that last floor, and now basically we're once again at the stage of we need to get Diplopia to give us some value here, because again we gave up a very good spacebar item for it. There you go, making sure I'm not shooting immediately, and look at that, we go straight to the boss, and I'll take that. We fallen. Okay, this could be good. It wasn't. It was 73% chance for a deal with the devil here. I don't really want Minecrafter. I want to see what's behind it, though. We one-tap it there, and it's glass cannon, as usual. Oh my gosh. Euthanasia just went crazy right there. Okay. Gonna bomb the Keeper just so we get a slightly better chance for a devil deal here. 78%. We can bomb our way out of the curse room, so this is no big deal here. The combination of us taking the negative and having the pentagram was a very, very, very strong move. Of course, now we have to contend with going up against Lamb, but things keep moving this way. We might have an easy peasy win. I'm not going to use the four room yet because A, I need an opportunity to forget about it, and B, I want to wait until we see what's from our boss. Or never mind, there's not going to be a boss drop. Well, yeah, then we just need to see if we have a reroll opportunity. More reroll opportunities in the arcade. This is where rubber cement really helps us here. This allows us to have, even if we end up not firing directly at things, thanks to the camo undies buff that we get, the very brief fire rate upgrade that we get, that allows us to still have a chance of hitting everything in the room. So we can almost use that camo undies buff effectively for everything in the room. If we're fast enough, we just have to be slightly accurate. So 78% deal with the devil. Place your bets now whether or not we're going to get one or not. Maybe the first time in a long time I've seen 21 minutes. And a Krampus fight. So, yeah. That would be a no. We did get Lump of Coal, though. But doesn't count as a devil deal because guess what? We didn't get a devil deal. Let's go back and use that four room real quick to see what else we can get. If we get lucky and one tap the glass cannon from the claw machine, then this is a really strong move here with the four room. But I doubt we'll get that lucky. What I figured. All right, so we get only one item pedestal to reroll here with the four room. It's a global D6. So let's see what we get. And we have produced. I mean, we could take Lard, I guess, for more HP. Because, like, our movement speed is a little bit too high, so, yeah, I'll take it. It didn't even affect our movement speed anyway. Well, it will, thanks to Camo Undies, but Camo Undies allows us to move at the speed regardless, so. Yeah, I'll take it. Maybe I shouldn't. Camo Undies. Wow, that phantom shot there. All right. Camo Undies threw off my judgment a little bit there. Get perks. Perks is actually fantastic for us. Gives us the wafer effect for a room. We can use that against. Well, we can use that in here, actually. Yeah. I'm going to use perks in here in the sac room so we don't get charged a full heart. The sacrum shuffle. Hopefully we get teleported, but kind of don't want to. Did the rosary, which is a tears up. Now this is going to cause us to. Yeah. Now we just don't need to. We don't need to play it anymore. Power pill there. Whew, I did not see those soul suckers up there. Now we've got some tech machine gun thing going on now. And this is why I love Tech 1, man. Even if it's a temporary tears buff, thanks to Camo Undies, we are still crushing it right now. With very minimal damage, I would say, for where we are. 7.25 tears is excellent. We go. All right, this is it, Diplopia, Incubus. It's gonna give us conjoined. Unfortunately, we do get Brimstone. Oh my goodness. Okay, so this is definitely worth 100% worth Diplopian here. So we are going to get conjoined, unfortunately. But now we're going to also supplement it with double Incubus and double Brimmy. I'm just going to touch the Bible just to have it for Seraphim, but also for Bookworm. Okay. Okay. Yeah, that's a pretty nice. And again, this is with very minimal damage upgrades, I would say. Double Brimstone is going to give us Mega Brim, and then on top of that, we also have the extra shots from both of the Incubi. Yeah, and then with everything kind of multiplying with the amount of beams that we're firing off thanks to Rubber Cement, we are in for a treat here. I don't even know what happened to them up there, but yeah, this is starting to get madness here. That Lamb's so thrown off, he couldn't even try to cheap shot us. Of course we're gonna do a victory lap. Come on now. Saturday. Second seed, Kilo, November, Victor, Charlie, 2, November, Zulu. It's a lot of Novembers. Jupiter, no thank you. We already have too much of a movement speed down. Now, what's crazy about this is because, remember, we have Camo Undies giving us a massive fire rate upgrade whenever we first enter a room. That's going to basically insta-charge Brimstone. Oh, my God. I actually don't want Tech X. I think Tech X is a mistake here. Get M. Fine by me. Wooden nickel. So M is going to re-roll our space bar item. Okay. We have the golden razor blade, and we're just going to take this one. Yeah, this is combined. This is a combination with Mama Mega and Mega Brim. I mean, just give up, game. It's over. It's all ogre now. Well, I gotta say that I think the Hinto Lime dunk rating is going to be just fine on this here video, because finally we get our first powerful run of the month, I would say. It's about dang time too. But June has a lot, and I mean a lot of work to go here before I think we can truly say that we've turned this month around. Because right now, like, yeah, this is a great run, but this is one out of what's today, the 16th, 15th, something like that. Go ahead and void the double tin rock I done saw right there. No. Yeah, this is cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs right now. Sure, might as well take another little Brimmy. I'm fine with that. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Going to absolutely smash. We're going to Invicta smash everything in this run. Invicta smash! By the way, if you're wondering why I'm just using our space bar item just for no reason at all, it's because I'm trying to roll through all the possible ideas for staying with a permanently staying with those one makes you smaller. Oh, now it's the follower train. Permanently staying with the space bar item. Balls of steel again. Okay. We just have absolutely nothing to worry about here. Now, I do want more damage. We're still cruising along here because we have Red Stew, obviously. And that's going to greatly increase our damage with this Brimstone. But I want a more permanent solution here. You'll use the D5 there to the de-evolve everything. No pun intended, of course. It's not even de-evolve, it's devolve. You know what? I am going to buy this. Let's see what's in the crawl space, shall we? You can guarantee a crawl space by using the shovel. Come on, game. By using the shovel on a piece of artwork, so like a blade of grass or a piece of paper, anything that's on the ground that is not part of it, like this little tuft of grass right here, you can put the shovel on and get a guaranteed crawl space. Which was a very weird but welcome change. Experimental pill range up. Even though it looked like it gave us the damage down, it didn't. That's the ticking debuff. That's the ticking damage buff counting down from Red Stew. Get a Guppy item. I don't know if that counts as a Guppy item, but I'll take it. And actually, you know what I should have done? I should have put Guppy's head down on that pedestal with Delirious before picking it back up, just to make sure that it counted. Because I'm curious to see if this counts as a Guppy item now that we got from M, or if we have to like solidify us getting it by putting it down and then acquiring it. You know, we like as in we didn't roll into it. Because sometimes the game gets kind of iffy about that. Okay. Well. So I'm purposely not using Guppy's head right now because I don't want to. I want to find a space bar item that we can substitute it with first. But of course, that requires us finding, like, you know, an item room. We just fire at everything because euthanasia is just gonna insta kill everything. That was Camo Undies like propelling us forward there at the last second. I was not expecting us to dart forward, but I'm looking for an active item. That's all I want here, game. It's fate, but it doesn't give us anything. In fact, it gave us nothing because we got rid of the Eternal Heart. Not that it really matters, of course. We can literally hit anything, and we're going to be able to usually probably kill them with euthanasia. Easy for me to say. Got the sack room here. Yeah, we killed the infamy skulls before they even had a chance to do anything. Take tractor beam. Still looking for a space for item here, game. Thank you. Okay, so let's see if need money. Let's see if it does actually count for Guppy, brother. We have Mom's key. I don't recall us actually getting anything with Mom's key yet. I think they've all been like single drop chests here. We need something better. Look, I will do the Sacrum Shuffle just so we can see this game. I just need 3 cents. How long it takes us to get there is up to you, but this is happening. One way or another, this is happening. Get the stairway. It's gonna be the one time we don't want the Seven Soul Hearts watch. Oh, okay. There we go. Alright, so we finally get to answer the question. It does rolling into Guppy, into a Guppy item, count towards Guppy if you use M? My prediction is no. My prediction is we're going to have to put this down and then pick it up. Yeah. Now if we pick it up and put it down, does that count? It does not. So yeah, so it just straight up just doesn't count, period. That's interesting. So straight up iron items acquired by rolling into them do not matter when it comes to transformations, which is really a really strange logic, but I think that perfectly summarizes most of Isaac. The tears up here doesn't really matter at this point. Take the Polaroid. I'm going to grab this soul heart here. So we'll take super bandage. The fool. And what we need a little bit of extra money here. I mean, we have 15 cents, which is enough for a premium item, kind of. But remember, we have the stairway now, so we want to try to save our money. Halo's good here. Give us a true all stats up and a full heal. Not that we really need it, of course, at this point, but come on. We have had a rough month so far. I think that we deserve a run like this. Definitely open up that chest there because need the moolah. I mean, we're smothering everything in brimstone here. Another damage up here, thanks to the pentagram. This is us having a blast now. Glyph of Balance. I mean, I'll buy one of these, but potentially could be some big money in here, but there's not. Bills. Look up. Smaller, appreciate that. Speed up. So now our movement speed's almost capped here, which is good. And I don't even know what we're hitting anymore at this point. We're just going in and blasting him. So anyway, I started blasting. I forgot to tell the story. So on Tuesday morning or Monday morning, it was one of those two. I think it was Monday. A YouTuber and mostly TikToker, but someone I've known of for many, many years, stopped by my Twitch stream because I've been following him on Twitch for a very long time now. And I've been following him on TikTok and YouTube for even longer. A guy by the name of Fredo on TV. And you have probably seen him without realizing it. He has a very, very large YouTube following, Instagram following, and TikTok following, 75%. And he's just all around cool dude. And I was very honored that he followed me on Twitch. Sissy! How you doing, little sissy? Oh my goodness. Well, that's the end of M right there. I guess we can use Wait What once. See if we get something impressive. But yeah, so Fredo followed me and I was kind of fanboying a little bit there, and I was like, man, that is real cool. Like I watched the man's videos, his reaction videos for many, many years. And yeah, it was just a fun time because it was out of nowhere. It was totally organic, and in talking to him in chat, he got to see a glimpse of the generosity of the mosh pit, and you know, we get along very well, it turns out, which is to no surprise to me. But if you want to go check out Fredo, just YouTube. All you can even Google search him, Fredo on TV, and you'll find him. But I guarantee you, you've seen the man's reaction videos, and probably not realized it. That's how popular he is. So it's always cool, and I love meeting new people in the space, and you know, Fredo's just a cool dude, and we talked for quite a while on Twitch. Somebody gifted him a Twitch Mosh Pit sub, and you know, it was just a good time, good vibes all around. Those kind of interactions really remind me that what we do here in new media in general, for the most part, is I don't want to say a lonely job, but you don't really get to go out and mingle too much. You know, you don't get to meet other people in the space. It's always just kind of like people who you've already known, or you know, through a friend of a friend. But meeting someone new, especially someone like that, of Fredo's caliber, is just out of nowhere was very, very awesome. And you know, and it's not totally out of nowhere, because I mean, I have watched his streams many times. I've gifted him subs, just to, you know, just the same reason why you would gift anyone else subs that you've watched for a long time. Just to, you feel not obligated, but you want to support them. You want to tell them thank you for, you know, just for being there. And I use his videos all the time to kind of wind down and relax, and I know people do the same for mine. And it's just always great. It's always just a cool event whenever I get to meet someone that I've watched for a while. And it puts what I do in perspective too, because like I wonder how many people are like that when they come to my stream, because obviously, like, to me, like, it's no big deal. You know, it's hard to explain. What I do, I feel like, is not anything special. I know how lucky I am to do this, and I know how incredibly fortunate I am to have the mosh pit and people who want to support me, but I never really think of myself as someone who's like known, or someone who's desirable to, like, you know, be like, hey man, like, I just wanted to say thank you. And it happens all the time. Even when it does happen all the time, it's like I still don't fully grasp, like, I don't fully grasp knowing what it's like to be even more well known than that. We don't want anything like that. But we're not really even using Jell-O, to be honest. Sorry, Jell-O. We've got tons of Jell-O at home at this point. Use teleporter here just for S's and G's. See if we can get closer, get taken somewhere cool. Worm buddy! Wow, we got everyone coming out today. Anyway, it's just always neat to meet somebody that I've been a fan of, and Fredo's a cool dude. It's very interesting and very awesome that we also have kind of the same outlook on a lot of things. Go check him out. Tell him your good buddy Sinvicta sent you. I mean, Fredo's got like millions of followers. Over a million subs on YouTube alone, but he really got started on TikTok, though. His videos are definitely worth the time. Right, now goes Boo Baby. No Delirium Portal, which is a little bit unfortunate. We already dropped M, didn't we? What is this trinket over here? I don't quite remember. Oh, come on. I was trying to save myself some time by not having to run all the way across the map. And then the one time we're like, hey, don't take us to the boss room. We've already been there. It's like, oh, you want to go to the boss room? It was dead tooth. But yeah, it was a fantastic run all around. And, you know, it's really good. It's refreshing. It's a little bit of a return to form run for us here. Getting a victory lap down and also getting just a super powerful and super fun run. So definitely go check out this seed if you haven't already. Let me know in the comments down below if you end up playing it. And thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing. And thank you to the new top five patrons as well on the Patreon campaign. They're not going to line up with the people that I'm about to read, but I want to say thank you all very much as well for the support on Patreon, on YouTube, on Twitch, on any other platform that you see me on. Thank you very much from the bottom of my heart. Have a great weekend, everybody. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Let's get this video over 3,000 likes. Come on, this run was a lot of fun. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Bataloid, Barman1988, and Alec Holloman. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find at patreon.com/Invicta.